nestled deep within the putrid flesh of my dead beast. With many of Highgate's tunnels now collapsed, we must forge another way inside. I have divined one weak point in the beast's flank, an ancient wound wrought by that Baalish overreacher, Doriani. The wound was healed shut by a thick membrane, but the right decoction should dissolve the tissue and allow us inside. Of course, for a cordial of such potency, I shall require two ingredients of utmost rarity. First, our viscous concoction shall require basilisk acid, a princely poison which drips from the caustic heart of the basilisk. And trathan powder, an explosive substance oft used in the mining of virtue gems. With these two bitter harvests, I shall brew something worthy of eroding the membrane of my decaying pet. Within the ruins of Highgate Refinery, you shall find it. Trathan powder, a slightly more unstable blend, but the kind found within the celebratory booklets and illuminations of Trathus. This devious mixture of crumbled chemistry was once used to blast holes through even the thickest mountainsides. It will ensure that our mixture has the brute force required, though one should tread carefully within the refinery. For General Adas and his elite legionaries sought refuge there during the first moments of Malachi's cataclysm. If they remain, they will be creatures of darkest discipline. Strong men in health and life, made even stronger in corruption and death. Basilisk acid drips from the hearts of those venomous monsters, though I cannot blame them for their disposition. They are tragic creatures. Theirs is a sorry tale more closely tied to my own than I care to dwell upon. Alas, the forging of my dark ember produced some rather unfortunate byproducts. But we shall not see any success if I am to dwell on those past errors. The dark ember remains nestled deep within the putrid flesh of my dead beast.
You can grunt all you want, lover. We can't stay here. Not with all this blood.
Where do you expect us to go, Vanya? We have our whole lives here, like.
I don't know. West, perhaps? The Ezomite lands. I don't care. Just somewhere that has unpoisoned water.
Oh, Beast Slayer.
Good to see you again.
Even if you have happened upon us in a rather unruly time.
Shush now, sweetie. There's no need to bother them with our woes.
Oh, they don't know. I can see on your face you haven't heard.
It's Kira. She's gone mad.
Absolutely bonkers.
She's abducted a Yon.
Stolen off with her into the desert. And to make matters worse...
The whole of Highgate is in a state of disarray. There's beast blood in the water.
Usurpers are eyeing up the throne.
And the old gods have risen. If you want my advice, get out of Highgate.
Or save us.
While you still can.
You must have encountered women like us before.
Relic hunters.
Is of rare antiquities. Anyway, Vanya and I are the best in the business.
And we need your help locating a particularly rare item.
Sweet, I was working on it.
It's an ancient sword belonging to the Maraketh goddess Garakan.
The Storm Blade, a weapon carved from crystal, capable of capturing even the most powerful of storms.
The goddess lost it somewhere in the eastern desert during her ancient battle against the necromancer Suresh and his undead horde.
According to
find the blade for us, and we will make it worth your while.
We'd do this ourselves, but what with the political unrest in Highgate, isn't it?
We fear leaving, lest we find the gateways barred and ourselves without a home.
Please, Vanya, don't say it.
Say what? I told you so? Well, I never trusted Kira. Her need to control everything, no matter the cost, was never a trait I held much faith in.
Yes, but ambition is not the problem. I have ambition. Do you not?
Of course, I trust you, sweetie, but you're not about to go killing everything that moves in exchange for a bit of power now, are you?
Well, I trade dreams of power for dreams of the wind, my sweetest, any day.
Oh, that's nice.
Yasha? Well, she's the best we've got. Strong, purposeful, and honorable one.
I think the description you're failing to provide, love, is stick in the mud.
Stick in the mud?
Yes, as stubborn and serious as they come.
You just don't like her because she treats you differently.
It Yarasha is a stuck-up elitist. She refuses to see me as a woman.
Oh, sweet. You're more woman to me than all of them put together. I'll let Vanya take this one.
Thank you, love. I trained in Ori.
As a witch, imagine that.
I thought I was telling this story, Pataris.
Yes, sorry, sweet.
I learned all about the old gods. They were supposed to be our idols, beings of divinity that guided us through our mortal lives.
Not like that at all, are they, love?
Hardly. The gods know better than we are. And nobody that is as bad as us should ever wield that much power.
As bad as us? Speak for yourself. I'm positively delightful.
Yes, yes, you're so sweet. They dipped you in a barrel of sugar as a babe. We know.
Good luck.
You must be the outsider, the beast killer. I am Yarasha, and while our soft-hearted chieftainess has gone wandering, it falls to you to make sure this Akara doesn't suffer for it. I've heard the stories they tell of you, and I know better than to pluck the feathers from a sleeping rock. Yet, for the sake of my people, I ask that you keep your peace while among us. Our customs have too often been threatened. Your ways are not our ways. Let's keep it like that. Oyun is gone for but a few days, and already Tasuni sniffs at the throne like it's a bitch in heat. Ruled by a man. You need only walk amongst the ruins of Sun to understand that folly. Well, his desires are but wants and lusts while Oyun still lives. One of my scouts saw Kira and her Dekara near the foothills. They had Oyun bound to the back of a rower like a hunter's prize. And the Sekema feather, a symbol of leadership, worn by her captor. Whether Kira works alone or in pack with her brother Tasuni, I know not. Yet I fear she means to sacrifice our Sekema to the vulture of the wastes. Garukai, please, this Akara has helped you in the past. Return our kindness. Free Oyun and return her safely to us. And if this quest is lost, remove the traitorous bitch Kira from this world and retrieve our feather. As long as we have that, the throne of Maraketh will remain safe. No matter where you come from or who you might be, we were all birthed by a mother. Our mothers protected us and gave us nourishment. It is our duty in life to honor that great task. Without a mother, none would tread this dirt today. The most important commandment in our people's tradition is this. Honor the mother. Honor the life. Arrogant men always seek to control that which they should not. As if that dangling piece of meat between your legs is somehow meant to lead them to power and glory. Men don't have the mind for leadership. Without guidance, they destroy all they touch. Leave the trials of power to women. We, who know how to nurture, how to grow, how to protect. Two of her very few outsiders have met with like assault. I'm not saying I think they should have as much sway in the Akara as they do. But the fact is, the people like them. Oyun like them. And despite their clumsy attempts to adopt some of our traditions, I like them as well. My head is still reeling from what Kira has done to Oyun. The bitch looked at me day in and day out and proclaimed herself loyal unto death. She has shown her true face in the end. Once I thought the other gods were worthy, and I can still see how one might think they are boons to be gained according to my favor. But if such favor comes at the price of Maraketh's lives, then I spit on the old gods, and Kira as well. May they all rot in the endless desert. I would offer prayers up to the goddess of the breeze as a child, and listen to her voice sing and whisper as she danced through my family's wind chimes. She was my favorite. But in light of recent time, I can only believe that some immortal madness has laid waste to her mind. Through treacherous deeds and blind love, gemlin queen has taught us much. The body remains here, surrounded by flowers, a reminder to all of us that we ought to tread lightly when chasing desire. Who can say, after all, where the line is drawn between bold ambition and foolish pride? My Dakara and I have vowed to protect our people, and so we keep our eyes sharp and our blades even sharper. As such, I have plenty of weapons on hand. If you perhaps need it to replenish your arsenal, I'm sure we can come to some agreement. Though you showed a mighty bravery when you slew that horrendous beast, by the thoughtlessness of your actions, you have caused great trouble to fall upon our home. The water runs red with toxic, corrupted blood. Now our people must travel far to fill their flasks and feed their livestock. It's as if we're in the midst of a great drought. All the water mocks us from within our own village.
Yes?
Yes. Cool winds.
May humanity flourish. A traveler on the winds, Garakan pridefully plundered the sky for its secrets. To her mind, wisdom could be found in the eye of the hurricane. Please understand that Garakan is not an evil being. She was once my friend and companion. Her beauty astonished me as her aspirations inspired me. Yet I must forgo my sentiments for the sake of humankind. Like winds erode the sandstone, Garakan has been warped by the same powers she enslaved. This is not my goddess that you shall slay. And if I continue to say it, I might very well come to do it. I weep for my poor Garakan. Together we experience the loftiest moments that this world could offer. Alas, it was my heavy heart that she would no longer bear. I knew her pride would one day be the storm that would ravage my precious humanity. In truth, it was for Garakan that I sailed the dark ember within the depths of Highgate. When love cannot be slain, it must be made down to sleep. Remember, humanity.
What can we do for you?
The nightmares are but whispers now. Yet. Like prophets, cowering within crevice and crack. They speak of old God's return and the reprisal of an exile to a beleaguered land. My sister Kira has grown obsessed with the vulture of the wastes, our goddess Garukan. Kira has taken Oyun and plans to sacrifice her, imagining she can reforge herself as a red Sakema. A warlord destined to unite the Madaketh under her bloody banner. My sister's betrayal is too great for forgiveness. Like a rabid dog wandering the mountain pass, she must be put down. I ask this of you, for you are familiar with such barbarism and will not feel the pangs of mercy that I would. On her person, I suspect you will find Oyun's royal mandate. The Sakema feather. If Kira truly wishes to take the throne, she would need such an item to be considered more than a simple usurper. Bring it to me for safekeeping. And please, return our Sakema Oyun to us if you can. If she still lives, that is. But don't risk your life for hers. I know her mind. She would not want that. Yes, I know of that dark god perched atop your shoulder. His image comes forth in my mind's eye, and I hear the sound of his breath crackle against the coldness of our mountain air. He has a different energy to the other gods revealed in my dreams. Less hostile, more empathetic to the plight which humanity suffers. Should his brethren be left to roam free? It seems, Lord Sin, as if you are on our side. In the twisting, shifting black smoke of my dreaming, I saw the beast. lying slain at your feet. I saw the rise of the old gods, the rigid, dusty remains, springing in sudden haste to life. I saw the growing of their power. As the corruption began to fade, I felt utter anguish, the madness of the beast's last rapid breath. Yet my sight, my power, still remains. It would appear that I was permanently marked by its corruption, even as I was birthed from my mother's womb. While now, my mother is no longer around to protect me, and the beast lies rotting in the bowels of that wretched mountain. Why ask me about her? That woman doesn't like me very much, and I can't say I'm particularly fond of her either. She seems to have gotten into her head somehow that I am the epitome of all evil, a selfish, blind villain. Nothing can be further from the truth, other than the blind part, of course. I suppose Irasha has good intentions. She truly wishes to see our tribe flourish. However, she is too caught up in ancient traditions. You see that for us to truly flourish, we must transcend tradition. We must become progressors of the future, not attendants to dry, dusty history. Tortured, yet unbroken.
did it! They found it, Bataris! They found it!
By the gods! Garukhan's famed Stormblade.
Do you know what this means, my sweet? Once we find the right collector...
We can go anywhere, have anything. We will be like royalty.
But the storm inside is a problem. It's too volatile in its current state.
You're right. We can't trade away a weapon of such apocalyptic nature.
This will require some kind of money. Thank you. Take your pick of our storm.
Of the Marrakech legends.
A truly unique cosmology of strange creatures, pagan gods, and powerful treasures.
One such story talks of a magical stone dial.
A Marrakech calendar, said to detail important events in the future of our world.
General Adis, a war hero of the Empire, reported in his diaries of discovering a dial meeting that description at a dig site somewhere in the foothills.
It appears the war hero had a secret penchant for archaeologists.
But the cataclysm wiped the land clean and buried the dig site in rocks and sand. No one has been able to locate it since, nor the stone dial.
Seems that with everything that's been going on of late, knowing what's due to happen in the future could be a fairly profitable ability.
We know you would never have for such a gift.
It would remove all the enjoyment out of adventure for someone like you.
Yet, in times such as these, our small folk could do well with a heads up if something particularly nasty were to occur. Besides, a relic like that should sit in a museum.
Or our collection.
Not be lost beneath the rubble where it benefits no one.
If you were to track the calendar down for us, we would pay you handsomely, Exile.
Yes, we are traders of antiquities, after all.
A noble legionnaire.
But a legionnaire, all the same.
Bataris and I did our research on Adis.
We needed to know as much about him and his dig site as possible.
To make sure he was worth our while.
The general was an eternal commander of the Highgate Legion.
He ran a mining camp up here in the mountains. The bastard was the one responsible for controlling Karui, Marrakech, and Ezomite slaves, forcing them into the black bowels of rockfishes in search of gems.
At least he treated them fairly.
A slave is still a slave, my sweets.
For all his faults, the general appears to have been a good man for his time. It's a shame what happened to him. Greater shame that by the same time he's come back.
Yes, we'd advise steering clear of his old camp.
See ya.
Yes? Be careful.
Until next time.
In the Marrakech Desert, an oasis lies to the east. Its waters shielded from prying eyes by a preternatural storm. The sand will rip the very flesh from your bones, should you be so foolish as to enter into its dark shroud. Yet enter you must. The goddess Shakari hides within that golden lizard, festering with revenge as she resurrects and rebuilds her ancient army. An army that once threatened to shake the very balance of these lands. Should she be allowed to revitalize her troops, the whole of Marrakech will finally fall under the cruelty of her selfish reign. The storm is impenetrable for now, even to the likes of me, but there must be a way in. These Highgate locals, they have an affinity for the desert and harsh weather. One of them may know of a way to disperse the storm. It is not something I deign to speak of often, but this goddess, this creature, she was once the flesh of my flesh, blood of my blood. I rose into the clouds and fell into the arms of the beautiful Garun Khan. Now, if you think that mortal marriages are difficult to navigate, try an immortal one. We parted ways, yet not before my young queen of the sands was born into this world of filth and horror. Now you see how I must suffer for the sake of humanity, to lay mine own daughter upon the sacrifice.
Well, it took some time, but thanks to our Murakef neighbors...
And their ancient traditions.
We managed a strain of thaumaturgy to remove the storm from Garukhan's blade.
We even bottled it for safekeeping.
We'd rather not trust anyone with this sort of power, but perhaps you can use it to clear away that sandstorm in the desert?
Find out what sort of nasties are hiding out there in the desert and put a stop to them. Bye.
Hello.
When I received my first flower of blood, I was given to the ritual of womanhood. All young Murakef women have to dance with a scorpion to prove themselves worthy of carrying the Dakara's spear. It is no easy task to catch a black Murakef scorpion. Their tails are swift, their stingers sharp, their poison lethal. I made my way through the trial unscathed, but my sister... We shared a room, came into this world together. She left it, fresh and falling at the mouth. Since that day, I have slept with one eye open for fear of the scorpion's sting. And now Shakari, the mother of all black bugs, rises from the sands. Fine, cut her in a bitch, and kill her for me, and for every child, every little girl who has suffered and died by the barb of countless poison tails.
I see and feel.